2007 VW Passat with a 2.0 turbo FSI engine. I'm told it's running rough. It sounds like a misfire.
174,000. Let's do a cold start. And it's shaky. Feels like a misfire.
Cylinder 4 misfire. Let's go into some live data. Okay, so I'm on the proprietary side now, and I've got the misfire counter up, and you can see all of the misfires are on cylinder 4. So I'm going to start that with the usual, just look at the coils and plugs and go from there. If I don't find anything there, then I'll look at fuel.
Let me show you how this goes on. This plastic cover is a bit of a bear, and it's connected by 4 posts. You can see here's one, here's another 4, and they connect to these posts here. So I'm going to put some silicone lube on these 4 posts to make it easier for the next guy to get off. Now here are the cylinders, and I've checked out the cylinder numbering. This is cylinder 1 and this is cylinder 4. And if you look closely, you can see that the plastic clips on cylinder 1 and 2 have already been broken by a mechanic in the past. But cylinder 4, which is our culprit cylinder, seems to be fine electrically. So this is the first effort. I'm going to take that off and swap it with number 3 and see if the misfire switches to number 3. Okay, I'll show you on this connector that's not broken. To get this out, you just pull this back and then shake it back and forth. You pull it back and forth and it pops out. So you slide the connector back this way and it comes loose. Now the connectors are off. I've taken off the 3rd coil. I'm going to take off the 4th now. Interestingly enough, these VW ones don't have a mounting bolt, so you just pry up and with a screwdriver and pull. And here it is there. Not seeing any tracking. There's no oil here. That part of it looks good. Let's put this one into number 3. Put 3 into 4. And see whether the misfire moves to the other side.
Okay, now we've moved this suspect bad coil from cylinder 4 to cylinder 3, and look what's happened. Now we have no misfires in cylinder 4, and all the misfires are cylinder 3. So that verifies that we've got a bad coil. Let's shut off the engine, take that out, check the resistance, and get another one.
Now there's another way you can do this, the so-called cylinder balance test in some vehicles. And basically what you do is you have a test light hook up to ground for your safety, use a glove, you have the engine running, and then you pull this out and see if the spark will change and see if the RPMs will change or the car stumbles. You do those one at a time. But here, because of the way the coils are all in one harness, you can't really do that very well. So you're kind of hooped from perspective of that method in this car. All right, this is the underside of the engine cover, and it doubles as an intake. You can see the mass airflow sensor right in there. And just peeking in at the air filter, it looks dirty, and so I'm going to take it out. Now, I think this is, metal thing is just a heat shield, so I think I need to undo all of these Phillips head screws to take this off, so I'll do that now. That doesn't seem to want to come off, so I'm going to just undo this heat shield just in case it's held underneath. Ah, this thing was holding it on. You got to take this thing off for it to come apart, and then it just lifts off. There's our air filter. Yeah, definitely needs to be changed. These plugs don't look too worn, but when a coil dies, most mechanics replace them all anyway. They do that because a bad plug is the most common identifiable cause of coil death, and if you don't replace a bad plug, your new coil won't last long. The coil has to produce a higher voltage spike to make electrons jump across a worn plug. That extra voltage can break down insulation to find a different path, and the extra heat can damage sensitive electronics. This is plug number 4. It's no different than the others. There's no tracking on the porcelain. I've checked. These NGK Platinum plugs are right for this engine, and I'm using identical plugs. Here's a dilemma. The official VW shop manual calls for a gap of 1.0 to 1.1 millimeters, and to my surprise, the gap in the new plugs don't meet that spec. They're closer to 0.8. I'd be interested in what you'd do here.
I decided to go with the traditional path of regapping. I'm doing this in a vise to reduce the chance of scraping off the platinum coating.
Spark plug socket is 5/8 or 16 millimeters. You need a fairly long one. And I always start by going backwards until I can feel it drop into the notch. There it is. And then I go forwards. And stop if you meet a significant resistance, because it can be a huge catastrophe if you cross-thread a plug. This is the first time I've actually torqued spark plugs. The dealer spec is 25 newton meters, which works out to just a little over 18 foot-pounds.
The other decision is whether to go with a generic coil or whether an OEM coil would be better. I must say I've been burned in the past with cheaper generic coils, and so this time I went to the dealer and got an OEM coil for about $30 more.
I'm in the habit of putting a little dielectric grease on the boot, and this is the new coil. You can see it's all stainless on the outside here.
Okay, that's it. The car purrs like a kitten now. There's more to do on this car. I've got an oil leak in the upper left driver's side, which I think is the brake vacuum pump, and I think I'm going to replace the seals on that in the next few weeks. And secondly, the crankcase vacuum in this vehicle is way too high, and so I have plans to replace the PVC system. I hope you come along. I hope I earned your like today. Thanks for watching.